happened, Jack?
There was a big fight, and it was a little guy and a big guy, and the little guy won!
That's good.
He beat up the big guy.
Was the big guy mean?
Yeah, he was bullying him, and the little guy couldn't stand it anymore, so he beat him up.
Cool.
Yeah.
Do you want to hear a story from the Bible that has the same little guy and the same big guy, and the little guy still won?
Yeah, I want to hear about it.
Okay. It's called David and Goliath.
One day, God sent the prophet Samuel to Bethlehem to do an important job. Told him to find an Israelite man named Jesse.
Wait, Jesse is a girl name.
No, but he's a man.
So guys can be named Jesse?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
That's cool.
One of Jesse's 8 sons someday would be king. At first, Samuel met only 7 of Jesse's sons.
Why did he want to meet them?
Because God sent him to Bethlehem so he could meet them. God wanted him, like, he sent him on a mission so he could actually meet them.
Oh, that's cool. Why not all of them?
I don't know. Let's find out. The eldest son, it seemed special. Surely God would choose this Saul boy to be king. Samuel also asked to meet the youngest son, David, who was watching the sheep. David protected the sheep from bears and lions.
Wait. Why are sheep in the same area as bears and lions? Lions should be living in the savannah or something. And bears should be living in the forest. And sheep should be living in, like, the pasture. But why are they all in the same area?
It's just in, like, a savannah kind area. Like, it's warm. It has, like, trees near it, but it's, like, a normal place.
Oh, that makes so much sense.
David protected the sheep from bears and lions with his trusty slingshot.
What's a slingshot?
A slingshot is, like, a stick, and it's holding 2 parts out of it. And then there's, like, a rubber part, and you put a rock in it, and you pull it back and you hit the animal with the rock.
Oh my God, I want one of those for school so I can hit people I don't like with it.
No, don't do that.
Why not?
Because then you don't like to get hurt, so why are you hurting other people?
Because I don't like them.
But what if they didn't like you? You wouldn't like if someone kept throwing rocks at you.
Yeah, but it's gonna still be fun. And I want a slingshot because I can, like, hit rocks into the pond.
Okay. But you can't hit it at other people.
Can I hit it at ducks?
No. Because they're living. They feel it.
Wow, why? Why? I want to hit ducks with it, though.
No. Why are you going to hit ducks with it? What did the ducks do to you?
Nothing. That's the point.
Exactly. So you're not supposed to hit them.
Okay.
As soon as Samuel met David, God said, "This is he." David was the chosen one.
What does he mean by the chosen one?
He means, like, the one that was chosen, the one that had enough good kindness and all, so then he could be king.
Oh! I think I heard about King David. Is that him?
Yeah.
Oh! So this is a story about King David when he was young?
Yeah, when he was not king yet, but he was gonna become king.
Ooh, that's cool. Keep going.
David was a gifted harp player. Sometimes he played songs from the current King Saul. King Saul was very busy. His Israelite soldiers were fighting a people called the Philistines. David's brothers joined the army, but David was too young to be a soldier. Instead, he stayed home and tended sheep.
Oh, so he was helping at home while they were helping in the army?
Yeah.
That's good.
One day, at his father's request, David brought bread and cheese to his brothers to the army camp. "Bring back news of them," Jesse said. David was talking to his brothers when he spotted the Philistines' most famous warrior, a giant named Goliath.
Oh my God! Is he the big guy in the story?
Yeah.
What did he do?
Well, we're about to find out.
Goliath was more than 9 feet tall. He wore heavy armor and carried a huge spear.
Oh my God, that's scary!
Yeah. Every day, for 40 days, Goliath had mean words for the Israelite army. He dread just one soldier to fight him. Give me a man that we may fight together, Goliath said. The winner could claim victory for his army. The king's men fled in fear from Goliath.
I would too. He's 9 foot tall. That's scary.
Yeah, he's very tall. David looked at the giant and went to King Saul with an idea. David said he would fight the giant.
What? But David is small and tiny like me.
Yeah, just like the little guy fought the big guy in your school, right? That's how the stories are similar.
The king insisted that a boy could not fight a fierce warrior, but David was sure he could fight and win. Finally, King Saul said, "Go, and may the Lord be with you." David chose 5 smooth stones from a stream.
Why was he picking up stones if he's going to fight the big guy?
Because he's using his slingshot to fight Goliath.
Oh, that's smart.
Yeah. David chose 5 smooth stones from a stream and put them in his bag. With his slingshot in hand, David approached Goliath. David told the giant that a sword and spear were not much for God. As Goliath prepared for battle, David loaded his slingshot and whirled it with all his might. The stone hit the giant's forehead and Goliath crashed down to the ground.
Oh my God!
Yeah, it's very cool how the little guy beat the big guy and he's over nine feet tall. David beat Goliath with a slingshot and one stone. Later, as God foretold, David would become king. And that's the end of our story today.
Wow! So David really did beat the big guy.
Yeah. In a big fight. And a lot of people didn't trust him in the beginning until King Saul agreed that finally he could try it.
That's good. Because David actually beat the giant.
Yeah, he beat him with only one stone.
I hope you guys learned something new.
Like I did.
And next time, know that just because someone's smaller than someone else doesn't mean they can't beat them. In God, they will beat them. Bye,
guys.